an insistent gnawing in the back of my mind. It was a yearning, a thirst for discovery that could be neither numbed nor sated. The courtyard and gardens surrounding the manor were once a point of pride for the diligent custodians I employed. Great banquets and lavish social affairs were hosted here under the stars. Despite the expectation of propriety normally ascribed to those in our position, we mocked the stoic melancholy of the moss-covered fountains and cherubic statues, our salacious trysts half hidden in the hedgerows, our morality slipping ever deeper into the mud. Soaked and sinking, these stone terraces and sprawling gardens were the site of long-forgotten revelry and well-remembered regret.
As the fiend falls,
a faint hope blossoms. Formation is broken. Maintain the offensive. Press this advantage. Give them no quarter. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. The maddening whine of multitudinous wings abates. Let us hope that is the end of things. Thank you. continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. A momentary abatement. Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken. Another abomination cleansed from our lands. Annihilated. Foolish horrors. Brought low and driven into the mud. trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless. Another one falls. executed with impunity. A momentary abatement. Powerful blow. This expedition at least promises success. Decimated. Made manifest. As victories mount, so too will resistance. Hideous mutation, unnatural and abhorrent. Thank you. the blood quickens. There can be no hope in this hell. No hope at all. Survival is a tenuous proposition in this sprawling tomb.
Thank you.
injury and despondence set the stage for heroism or cowardice. The sin is not in being outmatched, but in failing to recognize it. We fall so that we may learn to pick ourselves up once again. In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.